Today, I'll share with you my top tips and tricks for Google Sheets. Now, it's a combination of functions and features that I find really useful when working with data in a spreadsheet. Now, as you're watching this, let me know in the comments if there is any that you specifically like, and also share your own tips. Let's get started. Number one, scrolling tables. I want to create a report for employee information. I have name, start date, department, and salary of the different employees, and I've also added a chart here. But here's the problem. This part doesn't look so nice. Instead of having the data in cells, I'd love to add a scrolling table here that's the same height as my chart. Here's what I can do. Press Ctrl A to select this range, go to Insert, Chart. Now it's going to take a guess at the type of chart that's right for this, and it went with column chart. That's not what I want, so click on this drop down, scroll all the way down, and you're going to see a table chart. And immediately I get a scrolling table. I can adjust the size of this and place it where I need. Don't worry, I'm going to remove the data behind this, but I want to show you something. Take a look at the name here. When I click on this, it sorts it automatically, but the sort order of the source data doesn't change. This stays the same. I can quickly sort salary in descending order or in ascending order without changing the order of the original data set. Now for our report, we don't want to show the data here, so I'm going to cut it and put it on another sheet. And we have our nice report. Number two, auto-aggregate chart values. I'd like to create a column chart for department and salary, but here's the problem. Department is repeated multiple times because my information is more detailed. Well, that's no problem for Google Sheets. Let's just highlight the columns we need, go to Insert, Chart. It already inserted a column chart, but it plotted each single row. I want to aggregate these by department. So let's go to the side here, and for department, place a check mark beside aggregate, and we have the totals. Now I'm just going to select a series, scroll down here, and add data labels to this, and then it's just a matter of adjusting the size and placing it where we need in our report. One thing that's good to mention is that you have control over the plot area of the chart. So if you see that the title is kind of getting squashed in there, you can adjust the plot area. Now you can also get rid of anything you don't need. Just press delete and delete on this, and let's use the space on the bottom as well. Number three, publish to the web. With Google Sheets, you can easily create a web page out of your sheet. You can also embed your sheet in a website. Just go to File, Publish to the Web. You get to decide if you want to publish the entire document as a web page or a specific sheet. Now, the sheet that I'm currently on is called Publish, so I'm going to select that and click on Publish. It asks me if I'm sure I want to publish. Yes, I'm sure. And I get the link. I'm just going to copy this. If you wanted to embed your sheet on your website, go to Embed and copy this code. Since your sheet is published to the web, it's accessible for anyone, no matter if they're logged into their Google account or not. As long as they have a browser and your link, they can access it. So let's check this out. I'm going to bring up an incognito browser, paste the link, press Enter, and I get to see this page. Now this is live. So if I change the data, it's going to pull through here. So let's test that as well. I'll just change the first entry to a 2. Let's bring up our browser again, reload this page, and I see the updated value in the browser. Number four, column stats. With column stats, you get to quickly get an overview of the data you have in your columns. Just go to Data and select Column Stats. Here I can quickly see the different departments and the count of departments. When I scroll down, I get to see the frequency of each value and how many unique values I have. Now, when I go to this column where I have numbers, I get more information. Now, the count here doesn't make much sense, but I can switch my view to distribution to see the salary distribution. I get to also see the sum, average, median, minimum, and maximum values of my data set. A really quick way to get an overview of your data. Number 5, open-ended cell references. Now, I really like this feature because it allows you to easily account for future data. Let's say I want to sum the salary column. Let's add a quick sum here. Select the range, Control Shift up. Let's hold down Shift, go one cell down, close bracket, press Enter, and that's my total. But the problem is it's restricted to exactly this range. If I add new numbers to the bottom of this, it's not going to be included. To make this super flexible, you can remove the row reference at the end here, and this is going to go all the way down to the bottom of your sheet. So anytime you add numbers here, it's automatically going to be included. So you can fix the starting point, because in this case, I want to start from D4 and not D1, but I can leave the end open. Number 6. Insert date from a calendar. When you have a date in a cell, you can double-click inside the cell to bring up the calendar. You can adjust the date if you need to. Now, if you'd like this feature to be available in empty cells so that you can double-click in the cell and get the calendar, you can add data validation to these. Highlight the cells, go to Data, Data Validation. For criteria, change this to date. You can reject input if it's an invalid date and click on save. Now, when you double click in a cell, you can pick your date. To be consistent, let's apply this formatting to our dates here. Number 7, add checkboxes to keep track. To add checkboxes to your cells, highlight the range you want to have the checkboxes in, go to Insert, select checkbox. Adjust the color of your checkbox by changing the font color. I'm going to go with orange. You can activate the checkbox with your mouse, or you can use the space key on your keyboard. Take a look at what's in your formula bar. It says false when it's unchecked and true when it's checked. You can use this information in formulas to control other actions in your report. You can also use this information in conditional formatting. So for example, if the checkbox is checked, you can cross out this text. Let's quickly add conditional formatting to this, highlight the range we want to have the formatting in, go to Format, Conditional Formatting. That's our range. Our format rule is based on a formula, so I'm going to go with Custom Formula Is, type in equals, A4. That's where I have my checkbox, but I have to be mindful here of how I fix the cell references. I need to make sure that I have a dollar sign for A because I don't want this reference to shift. I want it to be fixed to A. Now here, I don't necessarily need to type in equals true because that's the default logical check here. All I have to do is decide what I want to happen to this. I could strike these through, or just adjust the background color of the cells. Click on Done. Number 8, pivot tables for quick analysis. To quickly analyze your data, insert a pivot table. Go to Data, Pivot Table. It tries to identify the data range. In this case, it's correct. You can add your table into a new sheet or the existing sheet. I'm going to go with the existing sheet and place it right here. OK, and create. I get the layout of my pivot table here, and immediately I get some suggestions. These help me get started faster. Average of salary for each department sounds good, so I'm going to select that, and I get department and the average salary. I can see it added department to rows and salary to the values. It has summarized by average. If I want to show the maximum salary in each department, I can select max. To get the sum, select sum. Now you can also add columns to this by selecting from the list of available columns. In this case, it doesn't make much sense to add name here. To remove it, just click on the X. You can add multiple rows as well, so we can go ahead and add name here. This way we get to expand and collapse our departments and have all this information in one view. To make sure we account for future data, we can expand our reference here. So I'm just gonna delete the 20, press enter, and it automatically expands it to the last available row on my sheet. This means if I add new information here, it automatically gets added to my pivot table. Number 9, web functions. Google Sheets has a set of very useful web functions. If you go to Insert, Function, Web, you can see the list here. With IMPORTHTML, you can easily import any data from web pages. Import Range imports data from other spreadsheets. And Import HTML imports data from tables on the web to your sheet. We're going to take a closer look at Import HTML. So let's say I want to get the list of national holidays in Austria. So I'm in officeholidays.com. I have Austria 2021 selected, and I want to get this table in my sheet. I just need to copy this URL, go back to my sheet, type in equals import HTML. Now paste in the URL, but you need to put it in quotation marks. Close the quotation mark. Next, we need to specify that we want a table. Again, we have to put this in quotation marks. And last is the index number of the table, because a web page can have different tables. Now here, you just have to take a guess. So I'm going to put 1, close bracket, press enter, and see if I get my table, and I do. This is a quick way of getting tables from web pages properly imported to your sheet. Number 10. Functions to organize and filter your data. Google Sheets has hundreds of functions to analyze, look up, and filter your data. You can see these if you go to Insert Function. Some of my favorites are in the Filter section. You can dynamically filter, sort, and get a unique list of values. So for example, let's say I want to get a unique list for department. I just have to type in unique, select my range, close bracket, press enter, and I have a dynamic list. The moment I get a new department here, my list updates because I'm using a function. I'm just going to press Ctrl Z to go back. You can also sort your lists dynamically. So if I wrap the unique function inside the sort function, I get this list sorted in ascending order. To have it sorted in descending order, I need to add false for the third argument. So the second argument is the sort column. In this case, I just have one column, so I'm going to type a 1 and false for ascending. So I'm going to get this in descending order. Now, before we wrap this up, let's take a look at the filter function. Let's say we want to get the list of people who work in the finance department. And we want this to be dynamic. So if we switch finance to another department, our list automatically updates. I first have to select my range, then my condition. My condition is that department, which is in this column, equals this one. When I close bracket and press enter, I get my list. And remember, you can leave these open-ended as well to account for future data. If this changes from finance to sales, I get the list of people in the sales department. I hope you found these tips useful. Please give this video a thumbs up if you did. Also leave your feedback in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.